Today, I want to talk to you about the easiest, simplest, most amazing habit that I've learned from Buddhist monks. But to keep the intrigue, let me first tell you, how did I get to know these Buddhist monks? I had a very complicated time of my life, which all of us encounter sooner or later, and I encountered mine sooner. 23, I think. My partner at that time passed away, unexpectedly died, and I had no idea what to do with my life. I was like completely shocked. At that time, I was living in China, in Kunming, and I worked as an English teacher. And one day at work, I was standing in front of a window, the sun was shining into my face, and something just clicked in my head, and I remembered an online meditation program that I had found a year before. So I rushed downstairs, I got on my bicycle, and I started riding back home to just find this program. And I sat down and I meditated, and this program was 42 day long. The habit that I'm gonna share with you is really simple, but it's only gonna work if you do it. That's why I'm leading up to it for so long. And I meditated for so long, for 42 days, and then I went to Thailand on my first ever meditation retreat. And if you don't know what a meditation retreat is, shortly, it's a moment when you switch yourself off and go away from the outer world in order to immerse into yourself. And that's the time that you dedicate to yourself. That you spend in meditation with some beautiful people, and it can be silent or speaking. Anyway, I arrived to Thailand to this meditation retreat, and there are two teaching monks, incredible humans that I'm still in touch with, and I have been very humbled to bring them to different countries and have them teach at different places. And they have taught us a lot during that time. And of course, meditation was the main practice, but our mind always wants to feed on some information. And one of the things that a monk said was, every morning when you wake up, you make a decision. You make a decision to snooze your alarm, or to go back to bed, or to get up and get on with your day. And very often when we are not so happy with our lives, that's what we do. We hide under our blanket. After this retreat, he invited us not only to meditate regularly, but also to make our bed. Because he said that making your bed is a decision that helps you separate your sleeping time from your awake time, and it helps you step into a new day with a good decision, with a firm decision. That's one of the first decisions that you make in a day. And that time I thought, okay, you know what? I don't have to make my bed, and my days can be okay. And I still think so. Not everybody needs to follow this habit. I'm just telling you how it works for me. And later I started implementing it into my life. So before, my bed would be messy. I would come back from work. I would look at this bed. I would get really chaotic in my mind right away. And now I make my bed. Every time I see that my bed is made, I'm like, oh, order, calm. And I know that you may not agree with me that our outer space depicts our inner space, and I haven't agreed with the monks very much on this before, but now I can tell you that it does, which doesn't mean that you have to push yourself to make your bed, but just willingly invite yourself to do it in the morning and see how your life's gonna change. So the most simple and profound habit that I have learned from the Buddhist monks is making my bed. It was also about meditation. I did really enjoy all the skills that I got from them, but this one is just so simple. It's a 1 second decision. You just come up, you make your bed, and you instantly feel better. And it shows you how making a good, resourceful, useful decision daily can change your life completely, because you get one good habit and then you attach another one to this good habit. You start making your bed, then you start practicing sports in the morning, then you start cold showers, then you start drinking lemon water, then you start making smoothie, and then you find yourself alive and vibrant and full of this energy, And that's what making your bed every morning can do to you if you commit to doing it. So if you're still watching this video, if you're still interested in this one very simple and profound habit that I'm sharing with you, I invite you to now commit to making your bed for a certain number of days after today and write it down in the comments. I commit to make my bed from today on for 5 days, 10 days, or a month. And when you make this commitment, follow through. And then you will see how things will start changing. Because every decision that you make in your life, it either makes you grow or makes you stagnate and stop growing. And if you make this decision right now, it's such a simple one that you will follow through. And when you follow through, you will build on this. You will understand that it's not about making your bed. It's about your relationship with yourself. When you make a decision and you follow through, and that's the most beautiful thing that can happen to us, the human beings who grow. Thank you so much for watching me. If you want to find out more about meditation retreats and how to organize one at home, once I do this video, I'll drop the link down below. Now, if you want to get more information from me about my events, about coaching, new YouTube videos, and my Zoom meditations, please sign up to my newsletter. I share all the information there first. It was me, Katia Kulyk, your life coach. And I want you to always, always remember, only you decide how bright you shine.